Look at you, look at you, look what you made me do. How do you figure my every move? Who are you, who are you? You look so familiar. I know you, baby, I know the truth. We got way too much in common. If I'm being honest.
Hey guys, welcome back. So my name is Luba, for those of you who are new to my channel. This is my third fall look. This is my last fall look. And I went for a more coppery feel. And for my lips, big surprise, I actually tried the ColourPop liquid lipsticks. And I had this one a long time ago, but since it made me really disappointed the first time, I never used it again. But my friend, the one that helps me record, she did tell me to apply on a lot of chapstick. And then some of you on the comments, when I asked for more tips, you guys also told me to put on chapstick and Vaseline, but I don't have Vaseline, so I just applied a lot of chapstick, and it actually does work a lot better. I'm sorry for doubting you, ColourPop. And I also really want to thank you guys, all of you guys who have subscribed. I already have 5,500 subscribers and counting. I'm not sure, I haven't checked, but I just want to thank you guys so much. My YouTube has grown in such a small period of time. I didn't think I was ever gonna have 5,000 subscribers in 4 or 5 months. I thought it would take like maybe a year or so. No, I really just choked up. I don't know why. But I just really want to thank you guys so much for always being there and always subscribing, always sharing my videos, liking them, commenting down below. I really love all the support you guys have gave me, and I just really want to thank you guys. I don't know what else I can say besides thank you guys. You guys have changed a lot. You guys have brought me a lot of opportunities that I never thought I would receive, and it's all because of you guys. And I don't know, all I have to say is thank you very much, and I just want you guys to know that I love you guys all, and I'm always here to listen. I'm not just here to upload videos, also here to be friends with you guys. And if you guys want to chat more with me, you guys can feel free to DM me or anything. But yeah, with further ado, we're gonna get started on this look. And I also want to let you guys know ahead of time that my video is actually gonna look a little bit different. The lighting is gonna go crazy throughout this video because I filmed kind of late. So let's just get started. So I'm gonna be using this color right here as my transition shade on my crease. Okay, so now I'm using this shade right on top of that one just to darken up the crease. Okay, so now I'm using this shade once again, just layering up all these light browns on my crease and on the outer corner. So now I'm using this maroon shade right here, and we're gonna concentrate this one more on the outer corner. So this one is just going to be applied right on top of that maroon one I just applied. And I think I forgot to mention, but I'm using the same brush for all these shades, which is a Morphe 433. I just feel like it's a really good brush to place colors and also blend. Depends on how you use it. So if I use it flat, I can just pat the color in, and if I use it like this, it blends all the colors in together. So we're going to be using this Morphe 431 brush, and it's just a pointed brush. It kind of looks like it's missing hairs. It's just a pointed brush that's gonna help us place the darker shadows exactly where we want them to be. So we're gonna be taking this dark brown, and we're gonna apply it on our outer corner. So now I'm going to take this flat brush, it's the M124, and I'm going to take this copper shimmery shade from the palette. This shade, I'm just going to apply it on my crease, kind of as a guide to where I'm applying the glitter. So taking the first transition color we took, this one right here, the one that's almost gone. We're gonna take some of that and just place it on our inner corner so it doesn't look so bald right there. And then once again, going with the shimmer. Doesn't really matter how much shimmer you apply, or I mean this shade you apply, because it's gonna get covered. But I just like wasting my eyeshadow. So I'm gonna be taking this NYX Face and Body Glitter. It looks like a copper color. So I'm going to be taking my NYX Glitter Primer, and I'm just gonna take a little dab of it on my arm, hand, foot. So now I'm applying that glitter right on top of the glitter glue. I went up too high!
Oh my god.
We have technical difficulties. We're gonna pause. Okay, so we're back. So I actually messed up on this item and I redid it. I don't know if you guys can tell, I'm just very picky. And it got really dark. It's actually, wait, we don't know what time it is. So I would tell you what time it is, but I can't because we're using our phones as flashlights to lighting my face. I also have my vanity lights on. It might make it look a little bit orangey. Okay, anyways, let's move on. So to highlight my brow bone, I'm gonna be using the Glow Kit. And I'm gonna be using Mimosa with the Smashbox brush, and I'm gonna be using this side of it, the pointy side. With the pointy side, I'm just gonna highlight my brow bone. Okay, so now I'm gonna move on to my face, and all the steps I'm gonna be doing are exactly what I did on my last video, so I'm gonna link that down below so you guys can just go watch that and see what I did with my face. And I'll put like the exact minute I started on. You guys would just see like a really speeded process of my entire face routine. So I think this is an explanation of why my face looks this white. So I'm actually using this Marc Jacobs Remarkable Foundation, but it's way too light for me right now. And I went to Target the other day to try to get a darker foundation because all my foundations are way too light for me right now. I'm not sure why. So I got this Infallible, the L'Oreal Infallible Foundation, and it was way too dark. I'm just gonna leave that there. And it was way too dark for me. I think it's in the color 003. You can't really read from here. Oh, it's in the shade 103. So that foundation was too dark for me, so I had to use a lighter foundation, which is this one right here. Oh my god, I hit my throat when I was saying that. But all I'm gonna do is just bronze up my face and kind of make it look not that crazy, because I know on camera I look really crazy right now, but in person it doesn't look that bad, right?
What? It fell in the toilet.
No, it didn't. Intermission, go grab a snack. I don't know why my face looks so white. I should probably take a picture to show you guys that my face actually doesn't look white. That white. It looks white, but not that white, you know? So for our inner corner highlight, I'm going to be using this Becca highlighter in Moonstone. So I actually was going to apply on eyelashes because I thought I had a fresh pair, but I didn't. And look how ugly, I can't even tell, probably I'll show you guys. Whatever, they look ugly on, like they look all separated and stuff. So I'm just going to leave my natural lashes on. When you guys do this look, you guys can go ahead and put some eyelashes on and look better than me. But so for today, I'm just going to leave my natural lashes on. No biggie. And now for my lips, I'm going to be mixing this NYX lip liner in Natural. Okay, so in my last video, I commented about the ColourPop Ultra Matte Lippies, or lipsticks, whatever they're called. And I did say that they're really crazy dry on my lips. And all you guys, I asked for like tips and stuff, and some of you guys told me to put Vaseline, but I drop everything. Some of you guys told me to put Vaseline, and others of you just told me to put a lot of chapstick on. So I actually put a lot of chapstick on. I have a lot of chapstick on my lips right now. So I'm going to be using this ColourPop lipstick, matte lipstick in Root. I'm not sure if it's like completely the same color. I just kind of messed up, but I don't want to mess with it because cleaning up red lips is really hard. So I can tell you right away, my lips feel like I still have chapstick on, which is pretty cool. And they don't feel that dry. It hasn't cracked yet, and I'm pretty sure it will. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of bronzer on my neck area because I feel like my face still looked a little bit lighter than my skin. Before, when I first tried it on, I did put on chapstick before, but I only put a little bit on. And then I put this on. Right when I smiled, my lips started cracking. Like, pieces of lipstick actually came off. But not this time. So whoever told me to put on a lot of chapstick, thank you very much.
Did I told you that like the first time you ever told me about that lipstick?
No.
Yes, I did. You're welcome.
Thank you. I need it. So this is the finished look. I really hope you guys found this tutorial easy to do because it was really easy. I'm pretty sure all of you guys can accomplish this look. It's just using one palette and glitter and a few brushes. I hope you guys do end up recreating. I hope you guys do end up recreating this look and tag me on any of my social media. I'm sorry, I'm speaking too fast. For those of you guys who did make it to the end, I want to let you guys know I have a giveaway coming up. And I'm going to have that giveaway. You guys are going to receive that giveaway. Like, whoever wins is going to receive it by Christmas time because I want it to be like a Christmas present. And it's to celebrate my 5,000 subscribers. Maybe by my next video or in 2 videos from now, I will show you guys what I got you guys. And that's about it. And if you guys have any other questions that you guys may have, feel free to ask me in the comments down below. Thank you guys so much for watching and stay tuned for my next video.
Bye.
Do you want to go get boba?
Yeah.